And welcome to the online worship service of Ada Congregational Church. No matter who you are or where you are on life's journey, we pray that you would find welcome here as we gather to be together and to worship God, to be filled up, and ultimately to be sent out, to do our best to love all and welcome all and seek justice for all. We pray that as we do that, that you would experience God's grace and God's peace. A couple of announcements as we begin. Next week is World Communion Sunday. On the first Sunday in October, Christians around the world throughout history have celebrated communion together. And so I wanted to make everyone aware of as we prepare for next week. It's a special week. We'll have multiple languages. All sorts of special things will be part of that service. As we connect with, as we are reminded that the body of Christ is wide and diverse. The second thing is, we have a friend named Kendall Leach. Many of you know Kendall. He's an alumni of the youth group. When I came to this church 14 years ago, he was a little kid. And now he's in college and is a film major. And we're so thankful that for the last 18 months, Kendall has edited together every one of our videos. I think it's 75 or more so far in the last 18 months. And so there's a lot of you who have been involved in these services, from reading and praying and singing and sermons and everything else. But one through line through all of them is Kendall Leach. And we're going to keep doing these services, but this is the last week that Kendall's going to be working on them. And so I just want to say a special thank you to Kendall. And he asked if he could record a little something to all of you. And so if you stick around to the very end, after the music is done, after the postlude, you can watch a little video from Kendall. Thanks, Kendall. You're awesome, and we love you. And then one other announcement. At our in-person service, which you're always welcome to join us in person right now, we're meeting in the backyard of church. It's a beautiful outdoor setting. Today, which is if you're watching this on Sunday morning, at 10 o'clock we'll be meeting. And we have a special part of the service as our theme, reconnect, restore, and rejoice. We've talked about reconnecting with each other, reconnecting with ourselves, and this week we talk about reconnecting with God. And as an example of that, Ed and Sherry Van Overen's granddaughter, Angelina, is going to rededicate her life to Christ. She texted me a couple of months ago and wondered if she could be involved and do that in that way. And so that'll be part of our in-person service. And so our scriptures this morning were chosen by Angelina, some of her favorites, things that have been meaningful to her as she, in her very young years, has had significant life experiences and has reconnected with God in significant ways. And so just wanted to highlight that for everyone. You may not all meet her this morning if you're not in person, but for all of us, even in this online gathering, these scriptures were chosen by one of our 12-year-old friends. Let's worship together.
Your word, O Lord, is eternal. It stands firm in the heavens. Your faithfulness continues through all generations. You created the earth and it endures.
Oh, how I love your holy word. I meditate on it all day long. How sweet are your words to my taste, sweeter than honey to my mouth. My heart is set on keeping your decrees to the very end.
Let us pray. Lord God, may your word be a lamp to our feet and a light to our path. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Father Christ, Christ our brother, all who live in love are thine. Teach us how to love each other, lift us to the joy divine. Mortals, join the happy chorus which the morning stars began. Love divine is reigning o'er us, joining all within its span. Ever singing, march we onward, victors in the midst of strife. Joyful music leads us onward in the triumph song of life.
Welcome, friends. Today is Bible Sunday at our church. It is the tradition in our church family to give a new adventure Bible to our friends who are in first grade and to any older children who may be newer to our church family. We have a wonderful group of children who will be receiving this Bible at the outdoor service today. Let me share the names of those children: Vivian Brayman, Emerson Garner, Hannah Schiff, Samuel Poplowski, Kylie Starr, Ellie Stormzand, and Gavin Verwolf. We celebrate with the children and their families and pray a blessing upon all of them. I love to share the new Adventure Bible. It has wonderful helps in it. Not only does it have the stories of God for the Old Testament and the New Testament, but it has special sections in it that are helpful for daily devotions of reading and also sharing a historical background for helping us to know what life was like in Jesus' days. I hope that you and your family take a moment to look through some of these special boxes and pages that are throughout the Bible. You're sure to read something you've never heard before. I'd like to say a special blessing for each of the children who are receiving their Bibles this year. Vivian Brayman, may God bless you as you read God's stories and learn of God's love. Emerson Garner, may God's word be a light unto your path. Hannah Shuh, may God bless you with the promises and love of old and new. Samuel Poplowski, may God bless you with strength as you read and learn and grow in God's word. Kylie Starr, may God shine his love upon you as you learn and read God's stories. Ellie Stormzand, may God bless you as you read and you love and you grow in God's word. Gavin Verwolf, may God's light shine upon you as you read and as you grow. Let us all say a prayer blessing these children and their families in an echo prayer. Dear God, thank you for giving the Bible. Thank you for helping us to learn through stories. Help us to learn to love you more. Send your Spirit to us and help us to grow. Amen.
Oh.
to my feet and a light unto my path. When I feel afraid, think I've lost my way, still you're there right beside me. And nothing will I fear as long as you are near. Please be near me to the end. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Fear not, I am with thee, obey not dismayed, for I am thy God, I will still give thee aid. I'll strengthen thee, help thee, and cause thee to stand, upheld by my righteous omnipotent hand. I will not forget your love for me, and yet my heart forever is wandering. Jesus, be my guide, and hold me to your side, and I will love you to the end. My word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. My word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. And a light unto my path. And a light unto my path.
This morning we're reading Philippians chapter 1, verses 1 through 11. I thank my God every time I remember you. In all my prayers for all of you, I always pray with joy because of your partnership in the gospel from the first day until now, being confident of this, that he who began a good work in you will carry it on to completion until the day of Jesus Christ. It is right for me to feel this way about all of you, since I have you in my heart, and whether I am in chains or defending and confirming the gospel, all of you share God's grace with me. God can testify how I long for all of you with the affection of Christ Jesus. And this is my prayer, that your love may abound more and more in knowledge and depth of insight, so that you may be able to discern what is best and may be pure and blameless for the day of Christ, filled with the fruit of righteousness that comes through Jesus Christ, to the glory and praise of God. Our next reading is John chapter 15, verses 5 to 6 and verses 9 through 13. I am the vine, you are the branches. If you remain in me and I in you, you will bear much fruit. Apart from me, you can do nothing. If you do not remain in me, you are like a branch that is thrown away and withers. Such branches are picked up, thrown into the fire, and burned. And now verse 9. As the Father has loved me, so have I loved you. Now remain in my love. If you keep my commands, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commands and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my joy may be in you and that your joy may be complete. My command is this: love each other as I have loved you. Greater love has no one than this, to lay down one's life for friends.
Reconnect, restore, and rejoice. Three words that sum up our theme for this fall. And that first one, we've already talked about reconnecting with each other, coming together, have an amazing church picnic and some great gatherings outside, another Wednesday night dinner this past week, some pizza outside with friends, mission opportunities, meals at restaurants, connecting with each other. Today, we're going to talk about reconnecting with God. And we have a great example as Angelina commits her life again to God, rededicates herself publicly, acknowledging that God has done meaningful things in my life. And the community of faith around me has had an impact. She's only 12, but she has some great things to share. It's inspiring for the rest of us. So reconnecting with God. And then next week on World Communion Sunday, we'll talk about reconnecting with the global church, with some of our church practices, with the table, reconnecting through communion, reconnecting with those rituals that connect us, that remind us of the rhythm of life, of the life of faith. And then as we get later into October, we'll talk about restore. What does it mean to put our lives back together? And we'll look at the biblical example of exile when the people were taken from their land, struggled, the temple was destroyed. We have examples in our scriptures of when the building of faith, their church, their temple was destroyed and they couldn't worship there anymore. What did that mean? How did they move forward? I think there's some parallels for us. And then as we get closer to Thanksgiving, as we always do in November, we'll have services of joy and thanksgiving and rejoicing. So restore and rejoice are coming. But right now we're focused on reconnect. And as we do that, I invited Angelina, who asked if she could do this here at our church. I invited her, what are some of your favorite scriptures? What stories or verses have spoken to you as you, because she had said to me, I feel more connected to God than I ever have. And so I asked her, and we'll get to hear that at the outdoor service, what are those things? But I asked her about the scriptures, and she shared a couple. And so we're including them today. And the first one is very similar to last week when we were focused on connecting with each other. We used one of Paul's letters. Last week it was Thessalonica, the church in Thessalonica. And this week it's the church in Philippi, two cities in Greece that Paul wrote to the Christians there to encourage them. And in this one, at the beginning of Philippians 1, he acknowledges, hey, this is Paul and Timothy. We're writing this. It says, who's it to? All of the holy people of Jesus Christ at Philippi, together with those who lead you. And then he says, grace and peace to you from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. And then he says, and this was the verse that Angelina highlighted, I thank my God every time I remember you. When I think of you, I thank God for what you've been in my life. In my prayers for you, I pray with joy because of your partnership with God from now and going way back. And then it continues, and eventually he says, and this is my prayer for you, that your love may abound more and more, so that you might be able to discern what is best, that you might be pure and blameless, filled with the fruit of righteousness that comes through Jesus Christ, to the glory and praise of God. This is my prayer, that your love may abound. All of the verses that Angelina highlighted had to do with love. And so as we think about what does it mean to be connected with God, to reconnect with God, well, 1 John 4 tells us God is love. And if God is with you or in you, then you will be full of love. And if you are loving those around you, well, that's God working through you. And if you're not loving, then, well, you might need to reconnect. And so one of the next verses that Angelina highlighted is from John 15. It's maybe a familiar passage to some. It's where Jesus is talking to those around him, and he says, I am the vine, and you are the branches. If anyone remains in me, that word remain or abide, connected, right? Like a vine and the branches rooted in the soil, connected, deeply rooted. I am the vine, you are the branches, he says. If you remain in me and I in you, you will bear much fruit. If you do not remain in me, you're like a branch that is thrown away, it withers. But if you remain in me and my words remain in you, you will love. You'll be connected to the Spirit of God, to the one who made us, to the one, Emmanuel, God is with us. And Jesus continues, as the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. There's that theme. If we're connected, then we love. And Jesus says, now remain in my love. If you keep my commands, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commands, and I remain in his love. I have told you this so your joy may be in you, my joy may be in you, and that your joy may be complete. So Jesus tells his followers, I am the vine and you're the branches. And as long as we stay connected, we are rooted in God. And then we will be filled with love. And that love then leads to what? Well, I'm telling you this, he says, so that my joy might be in you and that your joy might be complete. And so if we're connected to God, then we are filled with love, which leads to a life of joy, to reconnect, restore, and rejoice. Lives filled with joy, a community of faith filled with joy. As we love our neighbors, as we seek justice and welcome for all those around us, well, that shows God's love and it leads to joy. My command is this, Jesus says, love each other as I have loved you. And then he says, greater love has no one than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. So there it is. It's so simple, right? It's like a math equation. So simple and so impossible. If we remain connected to God, then we are filled with love. And then we experience joy. So simple. So simple to understand and so challenging and impossibly difficult to live out. Because how do we love those around us? And Jesus says, not just love those who are like you, love the people that are nice, love the people that are popular, love those with whom you can kind of get to know and thereby get things, right? Work your way up the ladder, improve your social standing and your network. No, he says, love everyone, love your neighbor. And one of the law scholars approaches him and says, well, who is my neighbor? I love everybody. Who's? And Jesus tells the story that we know as the Good Samaritan. But that law scholar in Jesus' day, well, they hated the Samaritans. And so the idea of a good Samaritan, well, that's there's no way. And so Jesus says not just to love the popular people or the pretty people or your family, but he says love the people that society has told you you're supposed to hate. Well, come on, Jesus. Now it's our simple little equation just got really hard, right? Who are those on the other side of a fence or an aisle or an ideology? Maybe it's idolatry too. But on the other side of some divide from you, from us. And Jesus says, love them too. And he connects that to our love with God. And so as we talk about love of God and reconnecting with God, it's impossible to get away from loving our neighbor. And then Jesus makes it harder by coupling that with, well, my neighbor is all of God's children, including the people that I don't like. Jesus goes even farther because that apparently isn't hard enough. And Jesus says, love your enemies. Pray for those who persecute you. So what does it mean to reconnect with God? Well, we want to be rooted, right? Abide, remain in me, Jesus says. Connected to me. Well, for some, that might be a daily devotional reading or a walk through the woods regularly, pondering God's goodness and faithfulness. For others, it's maybe singing in a choir and hearing the voices around you and being lifted up through that song. Maybe for others, it's coming to a table, acknowledging our own brokenness and accepting God's freely given grace. But whatever it is for us, individually and collectively, to connect with God and reconnect, and then remain or abide with God, whatever that is, the way we live that out, Jesus tells us, is through love. And love which leads to joy. And so my prayer for Angelina, as we celebrate her kind of public rededication of her life to God, and my prayer for all of us, maybe our prayer together, might be not only that we would reconnect with God, that's a great place to start, but that as we reconnect with God and we reconnect with each other, that our lives would be filled with love, so that love might pour out from us, and that love might change not only us, but change the world. Amen.
Devoted to you. It is cry of my heart to follow you. It is the cry of my heart to be close to you. It is the cry of my heart to follow all of the days of my life. Open my eyes so I can see the wonderful things that you do. Open my heart up more and more and make it wholly devoted to you. It is the cry of my heart to follow you. It is the cry of my heart to be close to you. It is the cry of my heart to follow all of the days of my life. All of the days of my life. All of the days of my life.
Let's join together in prayer. Holy and gracious God, we are so thankful, grateful for your love, grateful that we have the opportunity to be connected with you and with each other, with your creation. We pray that as we connect with you, as we dedicate our lives to following in the way of Jesus, that we might be rooted in your love, and that your love would fill us so much that our bucket overflows and love is shared throughout the world. God, there are so many spaces in our world that are desperate for your presence. Some of us are struggling, hurting, lonely, doubting, and just, God, we pray that your love would fill us up. And there are others who have health concerns and diagnoses and broken relationships. And God, we pray that you would bring healing and comfort where there is pain. And God, nations are at war. We pray for peace, peace that comes through justice, that people would value each other, that we would put our neighbors ahead of ourselves, that we wouldn't be so concerned about what I deserve, but how can I care for you? As Jesus said in our reading from John, that we would lay down our lives for our neighbors, that we would sacrifice our wants and desires for the good of others. And God, as we do that, that the butterfly effect, the ripples that flow out from each act of sacrificial love, that those would have an impact, that they would gain momentum as your Spirit moves in and through and among us, that the world would be changed, that heaven, shalom, would continue to break into our world. God, we pray for that, that your reign and rule would be present, your kingdom would be here, even as we pray together the words that Jesus taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Presence of the Lord.
And now as we go, receive these good words, this benediction from our reading from Philippians. May you be filled with the fruit of righteousness that comes through Jesus Christ to the glory and praise of God. Grace and peace, friends.
Reconnect us, Lord, make us one. Reconnect us, Lord, make us one. Reconnect us, Lord, make us one. Oh, Lord, make us one. Help restore us, Lord, make us whole. Help restore. Restore us, Lord, make us whole. Oh, Lord, make us whole. We rejoice, O Lord, hear us sing. We rejoice, O Lord, hear us sing. We rejoice, O Lord, hear us sing. Oh,
good morning. As you heard earlier, this is my last service that I will be editing and putting together. For the past 18 months, this has been an amazing experience to provide this service for my church. I want to give a special thanks to Rick Dykema, Ruth Rowey, Rebecca Risky, and Sherry Van Overen. They have helped so much these past 18 months to make sure that these services can happen. They've put in so much work and heart and dedication. I could not have done it without them. And I lastly want to thank you, the congregation, for allowing me to provide this service for the past 18 months. Film editing on this is a very big passion of mine, and it warms my heart very much that I could have done this for my church for as long as I did. So thank you.